H2O. The winner's circle continues with Eileen Khachaturian, who I had the honor of presenting the best rock album to at the AMAs last week. Eileen, it was nice to meet you on stage for the first time.
It was nice to meet you.
And it was a pleasure to hear your songs. Like, now, this is your first album in Armenian, in folk Armenian, but it's also got a twist. Talk about the different approaches to these classic songs.
It's actually, it's folk Armenian songs that we produced it in rock style. There is many styles of rock in the CD because it depended. It's the song that that gave us the opportunity to, you know, to do this kind, this style of rock. For example, in Karuna, the style is more gothic. Tirvortiak, it's industrial rock. Deleaman is more into electro. It's the songs that gave us, that permitted us to go this way. And of course, the mastering at the end, it was the whole thing that gave this album a kind of alternative rock taste.
It's a unique approach to songs that many of us have grown up with. Now,
yes.
You grew up in Beirut, you're Lebanese Armenian,
yes.
And you're here for the first time, or you've been here before?
I've been here before for a vacation,
okay.
3 years ago, for 3 days.
Okay, that doesn't count.
In California.
That doesn't count. But you were inspired to interpret these songs in the language of your...
My mother tongue language.
Yeah. And also the rock is what the current generation would be attracted to,
exactly.
Versus the classical renditions.
Yes.
So this was a way for you to reach these songs for the generation?
Yes, because personally, if I were not into music, maybe I wouldn't have listened to our old traditional songs. Because the recordings are, although they're beautiful, but if people are not, if you are not interested into music, maybe you won't listen to these songs, because the young generation have more tendency to go into rock, trip hop, electro. I mean, what goes on now. So I wanted to take these songs and turn them and produce them into rock version, because as you said, it's more accessible
appealing, yeah.
To young generations, to my generation as well. I'm a bit old, but and especially that it's songs that we listened to when we were young. So they're familiar songs. The songs that I've chosen for the first album are songs that are very familiar. It's not that they are very, songs that we've never heard about. You
right,
know?
Right. It's a new representation of things that we may have heard, but this is a new voice for a new generation.
Exactly.
A number of talented people involved in this project,
yes.
Midan. Tell us who was involved as producers and musicians.
I have two producers on the album. Is Mihran Gurunyan. He was with me on stage. And Mazin Siblini. The musicians that I work with are the most talented musicians. Jad Awad, he's our drummer. Haysam Shelhoub, our bassist. Mihran is a guitarist as well, and Mazin Siblini is on keyboard. I worked with a very, very good sound engineer who's very good into rock music, especially Philippe Tome. And the mastering was done at the Abbey Road Studios in London.
Wow.
So this is the concept of the CD. And of course, when I'm on stage, I have with me our light designer, Fadi Kassen, and our visual artists, Gab Fernandez and Amin Dorra, because the concert is a whole, is a tight show, is a whole concept. We have the visuals, the light show, the sound, so it's a show.
And the media that I read about your performances in Beirut mention the show because you actually take the time to explain to the audience what the songs are.
Yes, because I have a large audience of non-Armenians, and this album is not meant to be for Armenians only. It's also for the people who don't know about our Armenian culture, our Armenian heritage. Many people were surprised to discover that we have such nice songs in the Armenian culture. And this is my way to show them that we have all these amazing songs. So when I'm on stage, I explain all the songs. I give a small resume of each song so people understand what I'm singing, what I'm talking about.
Yeah, that information is probably as important as the work itself,
yes,
to kind of put it in context. Now, this album is getting a lot of airplay. Talk about the radio stations and where it's playing.
So the album is being played in Lebanon on Armenian stations and on the Lebanese stations. It's being played now, as I know, in the Czech Republic, in France, and it's being played in Syria, in Egypt, in
and I'm
Dubai.
Sure a lot of internet radio stations,
yes,
as well.
Yes, Last FM, of course I'm on MySpace. Yeah, I mean, it's being played.
And for those who want to pick up a copy of the album, it's available.
Yes, it's available online. So if they go on my website, there is a link that takes. It's sold actually at CD-rama.
CD-rama.com, okay.
In losangeles.com. On Amazon.com. It's sold here at Parcerian Records. This is in and at Amoeba. In
Los Angeles.
Yeah, in Los
so
Angeles.
Are people surprised to hear, let's say, Komidas with the goth rock sound or a rock sound? I mean, does that surprise people?
Actually, no. I was even surprised that people were not surprised. I mean, of course, there are people who are a bit old, who always loved Komidas. They were a bit... not unhappy, but they were a bit, they wanted to know what is it. So when I was launching my concert, I had many people who came to see what's happening. And as I heard from the echoes I had, people were very happy about it. And they weren't shocked at all, because it's true that my album is rock, but it's not heavy metal. It's, you can listen to it very easily. And the live show is totally different. I mean, it's not different, but for me, it's much nicer to see this album on. Of course, it's very nice to listen to it, right. But it's more nicer as well to.
Because of the visuals and the whole production.
Yes, the visuals, yeah. The light, the sound. It's another. I mean, you're in another world.
Well, I hope you bring that concert here to Los Angeles and we see it.
I hope as well.
Were you surprised that your album beat out all the other contestants for the best rock album at the AMA? Was that a surprise to you, or were you expecting? Because you love the album so much.
I was surprised in a way that that the people who were in competition with me were very good, because I discovered that I knew them. Some of them I discovered them when I saw the list of the nominees, and I saw that they had an amazing background. They were like at their third CD or second CD. So the only thing that I was afraid of, that this is my first CD, so I was a bit skeptic about it, but
well, congratulations.
I was very happy. I mean,
yeah.
it's a good. I mean, it's not because it's my album. It's a very good album. The sound is very good. It's a so. Why not?
you've been singing this album. Talk about when you first discovered your voice.
I discovered my voice very early, actually, because I, in my family, we have many pianists, so I used to play piano as well.
No relation to the Khachaturians from
well,
Armenia.
For my father, he says no. Okay. My grandmother, she says yes.
So the genes may be carried through to
exactly.
You.
Exactly. I used to sing since I'm young. I mean, you know, at school, the teachers discovered that I had a good voice. And I discovered that I was able, that I loved to sing when I was very young. I was 10 years old. And from that day, I really wanted to sing. I didn't know how it was going to happen. I did everything to make it happen. Karaoke contest, singing with other artists, and I did many lives. It's been almost 13 years that I sing live. So
you've also recorded in other languages?
Yes, I recorded a single CD 10 years ago in Arabic. It was an old traditional Arabic song, which is called Lamma. It was in jazz version. And in Paris, I recorded a whole album in French with Armenian influence, which was not launched. But it's good because I got to be done.
That's fantastic. So what is next for you? Obviously, more recordings are probably on
yes.
your schedule.
Well, when I'm back home in January, we're going to start the recording of the new album. It's going to contain, of course, folk Armenian songs. And it's going to contain as well original songs. Maybe we'll do some original English songs. Because people want to hear me as well singing in English, because when I'm on stage, I have a cover song that I sing, and I noticed that people liked it. So I'll probably record this cover song, and we'll do two more original songs, and we'll work on original Armenian songs. Maybe it will be Armenian poems, because we have such amazing poets, Armenian poets. It will be very nice to write music on it, like I did in Midan. We
right.
have there is a song Aravot, which is from Yerishe Charens, that Mihran and I wrote the music.
So how does the process work? You fall in love with a poem, and then you try to hear that poem and write the music for it.
Yes. We choose the poem, and then with Aravud it was very easy. I don't know why we came out from the first time the melody was here. For the folk songs, I usually give it to my producers, Mihran and Mazen, and they come. They feel what they feel with the song, and of course. They ask me what I think, and I listen to it, and I tell them what I like, what I don't like. Usually I like. I'm not very difficult, because I work with professional people, with very talented people. And I would like to add one thing. I would like to say that, as I said when I got my trophy, I did Midan because I had two people who believed in me. And these people are Nadim Farhat and Carole Babikian-Kokoni. And I think if I didn't have these two people, maybe Midan would have taken longer to be born. So I mean, it's good to have people. I mean, it's very hard in this industry if you don't have people behind you.
Right.
It's very hard to achieve your dreams. I mean, to get where I mean, if I'm there here because I had people who helped me.
And also, you had the talent and then this fresh approach to our standards.
Yes,
that
course.
Made people love you enough to hand you the
of
awards
course.
And write about you in Lebanese press and be played in Prague and all over
yeah,
the radio. So you feel like you're bringing back to life our culture in a way.
Yes, I mean, I can't say that I'm the only one who's doing this. I cannot put in position that I'm the only one who's bringing, but I'm an artist who are bringing our old culture, yes, back. And I'm very proud about it, because we need this. I mean, as an Armenian, for me, this CD, for me, it was a priority that the first CD has to be in Armenian. everybody can sing in French, everybody can sing in English, but not everybody can sing in Armenian. So let's take this as a quality and go forward in our culture. So, I mean, yeah, it's a good thing that we young generation, we bring these old songs back to life. I mean, to modernize them, yeah, in our style, in the style that which is happening now.
I bet your parents are proud.
They're very proud. Actually, they're very proud.
Very good. Well, yeah. I think, you know, right around now with Christmas season, it would be great for folks to gift this beautiful album, yeah, to not only their Armenian relatives and friends, but non-Armenians. It's a great way to introduce our culture and our cultural treasures to, yes, non-Armenians.
Yeah, of course.
Continued success to you.
Thank
Give
you.
Us the website again where people can find out more about you, watch your clips, and
it's,
listen to your music.
It's www.eilenkhachaturian.com.
And you can probably Google it and search for Midan, M-I-D-A-N, and Eileen's name. Congratulations again.
You.
And we hope to see you on stage here in Southern California
as well.
Performing.
Thank
you, Eileen.
Thank you.
And thank you. We'll be right back after this break.